Hey everyone, this is Carlos from Relics of Retail. Office Depot was a special place for me. As a student, I was obsessed with academic success, and buying the perfect school supplies was part of this. I made many trips to the store throughout my education, and I worked there for several years. Sadly, many stores have permanently closed since then. In this video, I will revisit the most familiar locations and share some interesting stories about them. This is the first store I ever visited. There's some really cool history about this location. This store is inside a shopping center. Before it was a shopping center, this land was the location of El Rancho Tropicana Hotel. For 22 seasons, the Oakland Raiders had their summer training camp on the hotel property. The Raiders would live in Santa Rosa for 3 months of the year. They won all three of their Super Bowl championships during this period, two as the Oakland Raiders and one as the Los Angeles Raiders. Many players and staff have fond memories of this training camp and the city of Santa Rosa. Afterwards, the Raiders' summer training camp was moved to Oxnard, my first hometown. When the Raiders moved back to Oakland, their training camp was located in Napa, not in Santa Rosa. They stayed there from 1996 to 2019. Then in 2020, when they became the Las Vegas Raiders, their training camp moved to Henderson, Nevada. After the Raiders' departure, El Rancho Tropicana Hotel was renovated into a first-class hotel. It went on to host conventions, concerts, boxing matches, and other events. The hotel closed in 1993 after 44 years of operation. The property was demolished in August 1994, and the Santa Rosa Marketplace Shopping Center was subsequently built in its place. Target was the first store to open in October 1995, and Office Depot opened shortly afterwards. I remember back to school shopping here for middle school and for high school. Back then, the store looked more like a warehouse. Its high shelves made the store feel like a maze. I remember pacing the aisles and having trouble finding items on my supply list. They were probably easy to find, but I was anxious and excited to start the new school year. There's a metallic scraping sound that you're gonna hear in a little bit. That sound was from a manager removing carpet panels with a scraper. Underneath the carpet was the white floor I remembered when I worked there one summer break. When I asked the manager why the store was closing, she said she wasn't given a specific reason. My last visit to the store was in October 2020, and by late November, the building was vacant, and it remained that way for over a year. In May 2022, a small Burlington store was opened in the space. The space was renovated, and only the ceiling seems the same. I was sad to see the Office Depot gone, but I'm glad the Burlington store was busy. Now let's travel to San Jose, California. I used to live in the area from the early 2000s to the early 2010s. During that time, San Jose had four Office Depots. Today, in 2022, they have zero. Let's check out these four locations. This dialysis clinic used to be an Office Depot. I remember it was a small store with a low ceiling. This former office depot was converted into Wagley Veterinary Hospital and Pet Campus. In April 2022, the Home Depot next door was burned to the ground after a man tried to create a distraction in order to shoplift. The Vet Hospital and Pet Campus is temporarily closed after sustained damage following the fire at the Home Depot. As of this writing, the suspect was arrested and charged. If convicted, he faces 14 years to life in prison. Fortunately, no people or animals were injured in the massive fire that took 6 hours to contain. I used to live near this former Office Depot. A few of my former coworkers worked at the store, and they said that it would get insanely busy during the back-to-school season. This area of San Jose is densely populated, and it has many schools in the area, so it's difficult to believe that this store would close. The store was transformed into Chavez Supermarket. I bought some of this sweetbread and it was good. I really like the signage and colorful aesthetics throughout the store. I worked at this store for several years, so I was especially sad to see it closing. During this visit, the store had 8 days until its permanent closure.
Office Depot.
Bigger stores, better prices. Taking care of business. Taking care of business.
The store interior felt surreal because many of the fixtures and walls were removed, but as I continued walking around, I could travel back to my 20s. It was a memorable time, going to college during the day, then working here in the evenings and on weekends. Many of my coworkers were close in age, and I got along great with a lot of them. I remember the busy shifts, challenging work situations, and a lot of nice customers. I remember sharing many laughs and great conversations with coworkers during work, and we also had a lot of fun when we met up for drinks. As I was filming, a manager approached me and we started talking. He said that the store was closing because of a lease dispute, but I think there's other reasons. There's a Staples store 1.6 miles away, and it has a better location. It's adjacent to the soccer arena of the San Jose Earthquakes, and the airport is across the street. If office supply stores struggled in recent years, I imagine they struggled more by being so close to each other. Then you add the pandemic, which created even more challenges. I returned to my old store on Coleman Avenue, and I noticed it was being transformed into a Sprouts supermarket. Currently, there is no Office Depots in San Jose, but there is an OfficeMax. The two companies merged back in 2013. This OfficeMax is very close to the former Office Depot that became a Vet Hospital and Pet Campus. OfficeMax stores carry office brand products, so the brand lives in San Jose in this way. As I mentioned earlier, Many office steeples have closed in recent years. A 2020 study estimated that 45% of office supply stores would close from 2020 to 2026. Maybe things won't be that grim. One expert recently said that Staples, Office Depot, and OfficeMax did well during the pandemic. But now that things have opened back up, time will tell how these stores do in the future. My experiences with Office Depot coincided with new chapters in my life. Starting middle school and high school, working there during college, and after I graduated. That's why it's sad to see that so many stores have disappeared. But I am grateful that these buildings still stand, and I was able to document these places that were meaningful. If you liked my video, please consider subscribing to my channel. Watch my other short documentaries, and follow me on Instagram where I post additional content. Thank you for watching. Thank you.